Good morning everyone, I am Yashika from class 11. Today I am going to explain the explanation of Newton's cradle. So it is Newton's cradle. So guys, if I pull one ball, then the motion will be transferred only in one ball. If I pull two balls, then the last two balls will move. If I pull three balls, then the last three balls will move after the collision. Now if I pull four balls, the four balls will be moved. So it may look easy and interesting, but complex to understand. So let me explain you the physics behind this. It works on three principles. First, law of conservation of linear momentum. Second, law of conservation of energy. And third, Newton's third law of motion. So when we lift the first ball, we are actually storing the gravitational potential energy. As soon as the ball is released, the potential energy gets transferred to the kinetic energy and the ball is moved. As the first ball collides with the second ball, all momentum and the energy get transferred to the second ball. As they are doing almost perfectly elastic collision, thus all the energy get remain conserved. When the first ball collides, the remaining five balls should have the 1/5 be the velocity ball, but this is not happening there. Only the last ball will move after the collision. So let's understand this with Newton's third law of motion. As soon as the first ball collides with the second ball, and all momentum and the energy get transferred to the second ball. The second ball get transferred, the all momentum and the energy to third ball, and third ball get transferred to the fourth ball. Finally, the all momentum and the energy get transferred to the fifth ball. So fifth or the last ball is moving after the collision, and fifth or the last ball, as no ball there is stop to it from its moving. So when we are two balls are striked and one ball move, so we had assumed that two balls are striked and only one ball move. So law of conservation of energy, the total initial kinetic energy it will be equal to the total final kinetic energy. Here is 2 is being then multiplied because two balls are striked. So here is 2 is being multiplied because two balls are striked, and the final velocity should have the total 1.41 times the initial velocity of the time. But according to law of conservation of momentum, the initial momentum will be equal to the total final momentum. And the solving the equation, the final velocity is 2 times the initial velocity of the time. But law of conservation of momentum, the final velocity should have 2 times, and the law, according to law of conservation of energy, the total final velocity should have 1.4 times. So the which the contrary and the law of conservation of momentum gets violated. Oh yeah.